CK. Forget Barbie, fuck Nikki, she's fake.
Pink wig, thick ass, give them whiplash. I think big, get cash, make them blink fast. Now look at what you just saw, this is what you live for. I'm a motherfucking monster.
Well, fan, and I hope you're watching now, bitch. I don't have enough subscribers to reach him. He wanted to talk to my mother. He wanted to talk to mommy. Mom took me to a goddamn barbershop. And the way I was sitting in that chair, holding on for dear life, when I was ready to kill someone, I was ready to pick up one of these fucking clippers and go in on someone's neck. It was insane.
I move in silence. Y'all know nothing about this shit. I'm thinking about getting chicken wings for dinner. But y'all wouldn't have known that, because I move in silence.
My team's too bad, I'm crazy. Y'all been trying to show me.
I'm so tired. I'm actually fucking exhausted. Hey, let me turn the exposure up, because you know I look fucking disgusting today. Yo, I've been trying to film. I'm one thing I'm not. Yo, there's been like 5 videos. They all fell by the fucking wayside. One I did, I didn't like. Another one I did, wasn't a fan. Another one I did, it stopped midway. Because I ran out of storage. Just deleted a whole bunch of fucking videos so I don't have to face that problem anymore. The fourth one wasn't a fan again. Then what I did, absolute perfection. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm not trying to aim for perfection. I don't want you to think I'm having such a hard time with like, no, I don't mind re-recording things again. Like it's not a big deal. If I don't like something, I don't mind re-recording it and doing it over. I really don't. Like, it's not as big of a deal as it sounds like. The last one was perfect, but I deleted it. And y'all probably wondering, how do you delete something and there's a recently deleted folder? Yes, that's the answer. I deleted it and went to the recently deleted and then deleted it. It was perfect. Am I stupid? Yep. So, you know, I wanted to come on here and talk about, right, let's move on. I wanted to come on here and, wait, is this the hairstyle I'm choosing? Because at one point I was going to do a get ready with me, but then I was like, bitch, I don't do anything to get ready. I don't do anything.
We can tell.
I really don't. I wanted to talk about what it was like growing up with 4C hair. It didn't make no goddamn sense. I went to boarding school for like 7 years of my life, starting at like 2nd grade. We had residential advisors, just like how they do in college. The way that the RAs and the teachers were on my ass like white on rice was insane. For one, at first, they liked me because they saw I was a nice person. They saw I was this nice person, you know, I was smiling. They was always talking about my cheeks. Oh my God, his cheeks, he's so nice, blah, blah, blah. And then they started to hate me because they realized that me being nice didn't mean that I was gonna have nice grades. Which, I mean, bitch, that's on you. Why would you ever assume that from me? Like, what did you want? Just because I was a nice person, like, what the hell? That's when the animosity started. That's when they started losing their goddamn marbles. But then it transformed. Shit done transmuted on them. They started having a problem with my hair, y'all. The way that my hair wasn't probably even, it wasn't even at this height. It wasn't even at this length. And they were attacking me out the gate. I was ready to fight somebody, yo. I was ready to fight somebody because, no, why were they so obsessed with me like this? Like, there was no reason why they should have been like on my ass this badly. The thing is, like, every man at that school, it was a boarding school, so the shit was big. Every guy at that school had a close cut. Everyone looked the fucking same, baby. Everyone looked the fucking same. And I'm like, why y'all wanna look like goddamn twins in this bitch? It was sick. They all looked exactly the same. And no offense to them, they was cool people, but like, they all looked the same. They was all wearing the same Hollister shirt with the bird on it. I'm like, bitch, all that did was remind me that you have a bird chest. Okay, so why the hell are you obsessed with wearing this bird on your chest? It didn't make no sense. They was wearing the Hollister. They was wearing the Abercrombie and Fitch. I don't even know what that means. Is that somebody's name? What is that? Who would name their kid something so goddamn horrendous? It was just, I didn't understand. I didn't get it. So everybody was looking the same at that school. So I was trying to change it up. I was trying to look like, you know, my own person, hello. And the teachers didn't like it. The teachers, the residential advisors, they weren't fans, but at the same time they were. because why were y'all obsessed with me like this? So it was a lot of pulling me to the sides. It was a lot of, hey, you know, come over here. Let's chat. No, it's not even like the white teachers were saying this. No white teacher came for me. That's the shocking part. That's the part that shook me for a shamble. They didn't come for me. They was not on me. They was normal, right? It was the black teachers that were on my back. It was the black teachers and the black RAs. They was on my back like a pack. It didn't make any sense. It was fucking scary. They would pull me to the side and be like, you know, you need to be more cleansly, more manly. You know what I see? You know, I think you should cut your hair. It's not, you know, it's not really blah, blah, blah. I'm like, what? For one, y'all don't know what I was trying to do with this hair. Because there were some residential advisors that had dreadlocks. So why could they have dreadlocks? But I couldn't have my little blown out afro. You know, I had a blow dryer. So I'll blow out my hair, you know. It was sickening. I was like, whoa, far sick for being this freaking obsessed with what I'm doing with my hair. Someone needed their ass beat. What am I doing with this? Because I was doing this the other day, like having it be split, and I had kind of liked it. So I might go for that. I'll see how it looks and then I'll decide. But yeah. But yeah. You know, they would be on me and I was just like, yeah, I'm not having it, bitch. Until this one RA, this one residential fat ass bitch on my back. Like my back like no other backs could ever back. For one, this man was scary as hell. If I want to give y'all the image, and I think the image I can say that can sum up the way he looked the most, think of Dr. Eggman from Sonic. Yes. If you know about Sonic, very much Dr. Eggman, but black. This man was bald and big. See, that's the issue. This man carried all the insecurities in the world, and he pushed them onto me. Of course, he was a fan. And I hope you're watching now, bitch. I don't have enough subscribers to reach him. I don't know, he probably did. All right, let's not wish death on people. Well, I didn't. I just assumed that he died. So, oh, I'm like a butterfly. What did that have to do with a butterfly? Like, what the fuck? What are you doing? Fucking scary. So I was just doing me, and this man, you know, he's telling me that I need to cut my hair. Like, it was a prerogative for him to get me to cut my hair, to cut thy hair. I didn't get it. I was like, why are you upset? For one, you of all people, how does it look for your big, bald, fat ass to tell me to cut my hair? That's it. Of all the people in the world, you're actually sitting here trying to declare that I must cut thy hair? That's sick. Oh, you know, once he realized that I was not taking his advice into consideration, because bitch, why would I take advice from a bald bitch? I would never. Once he realized I wasn't following with the shit, he went directly to the source. Yeah. He went to the goddamn source. He wanted to talk to my mother. He wanted to talk to mommy. We got picked up on Fridays. So when my mom came in to pick me up, he gonna take her to the side too. You know how he been taking me to the side? He gonna take her to the side now. Telling her about how my hair is uncleansly and stuff like that. And look, my hair probably wasn't the best in town. There was not that many videos about having type 4 hair back then. So, you know, it was not like the normal shit. Like, it was, it just wasn't like how it is now where there's so much information available. And even if there was, I probably wouldn't even known how to access it. I probably wouldn't have thought to, because I was in my own world. I didn't think anything was wrong with my hair. And like I said, it was shorter than this. But they didn't want anybody to look that different. They wanted assimilation, bitch. They wanted everyone to be the goddamn same. And it was sick. I had to be like 13. I was young as shit. Now, that was on my ass for years. But, you know, once I got older, it's like, you can only tell me about so much. I ain't doing shit. Why are y'all this obsessed with me? Why are so obsessed with me? I don't even know if this looks good. Y'all tell me. But I just didn't get it. He's telling her I need to cut my hair. And my mom was always trying to do the best for me. So, her being told that, you know, this needed to happen for this and that reason, she thought it was actually a legit reason. She was convinced that, okay, like, that's a legit reason. She knew it was, like, later on, like, years later, she's like, yeah, that was weird that, you know, I actually let him convince me to do that because that was weird. But so my mom took me to a goddamn barbershop. And the way I was sitting in that chair, holding on for dear life, because I was ready to kill someone. I was ready to pick up one of these fucking clippers and go in on someone's neck. It was insane. I'm sitting in the chair like,
get off me, dickhead.
Don't you touch me, dickhead. I was shook to the fucking core.
And I felt like my soul had got cut off. I felt like something had happened to my soul. Something had happened to my heart. The reason why I know this man had insecurities to the max, because when I went back to school, this man legitimately asked me, don't you feel lighter and thinner now? Excuse me, bitch? One, I was never trying to impress anyone. That's people's biggest issue that they don't seem to realize. They didn't seem to understand that with me. I wasn't trying to impress anyone. I was living my life. I was 13, I was 12, 13, however old I was. I was young. I didn't give a shit about that stuff. I was living my life like a kid should. But they was focused on my looks like they wanted me to be a model. And yes, bitch, I probably had the potential. That's all potential with me. And that's why y'all were obsessed. But I just was hated at that school. I was hated for my grades. I was hated for my body. And I was hated for my hair. It wasn't even the students, though. It's not like I was bullied by the students. I was bullied by the adults. The adults caused trauma, bitch. It wasn't the students. They was chill. They was on my ass every now and then about this, this, and that, and the third. But, okay, they were young. We were all young. The fuck? It didn't matter. So, that really shook me to the fucking bone. That shook me to the core, bitch. And it made me want to rain hellfire on that entire campus because the way that they were obsessed with me. That's about it. That's what happened. Yeah, this is the look. Was this really supposed to be a get ready with me for real? Like, this wasn't even a... I might put it in the title just for clickbait. So yeah, I really was trying to deliver for y'all. It's giving you need to wrap this the fuck up.
Hey, you guys.
What is that on my nose? Oh, someone need their ass beat. That wasn't even anything. Turn the video off, bitch. The fuck?